This is Shred, and welcome to Music Theory Class. In this video, I'll provide a basic introduction to music theory, including how to read music or the notes on the staff, key signatures, intervals, chords, and we'll also look at the jazz standard Autumn Leaves to tackle seventh chords. Now, I want to emphasize from the onset here that music theory is just a tool to help you get what you want. Don't get caught up in this idea that if you violate the rules of music theory, you're doing something wrong. If it sounds good, it is good. You can grab the full tabs for this video at my Patreon page below. All you gotta do is sell your soul to me on the dotted line. Small price to pay for ultimate music theory power. So make music theory your and let's get to it. Step one in your music theory journey is to learn some basic musical notation. It's not about becoming the world's most insane sight reader. All we're really going for is to learn the notes on the staff so that you can quickly absorb musical ideas. Now you might be asking yourself, why would I learn musical notation when there's tab? And the answer is, because I said so. Nah, just kidding. Musical notation offers a number of advantages over tab. Mainly the clear identification of chords and scales. For instance, it's way easier to recognize a D major 7 sharp 11 chord in notation when you can see the notes, as opposed to looking at a sea of numbers. Okay, so let's look at the notes on the staff. First up, you've got E, G, B, D, and F on the lines. Now you can remember these notes with the acronym Every Good Boy Does Fine. Now this is basically imploring you to be a simp, which is bad life advice, but it will help you remember the notes. Next you learn the notes on the spaces, which are F, A, C, and E, which spells the word face. As in hammer smashed face. Okay, once you get that going, try learning the notes in the first position. These are basically the notes that cover the span of the first few frets. Easy money, right? Now you're ready to tackle Flight of the Bumblebee. Bzzz. Now, rhythm is very important when it comes to reading music. So let's talk about some of the common rhythmic values you'll encounter. I've got my metronome set to 60 beats per minute. And the first rhythm we'll check out is whole notes, or 4 beats per note. Next is dotted half notes. This would be 3 beats per note. Now we move on to half notes, or 2 beats per note. I'm half the note I used to be. Now we have quarter notes, or 1 note per beat. Quarter note triplets is next. This is 3 notes in the space of 2 quarter notes. eighth notes or two notes per beat is next. And now eighth note triplets or three notes per beat. Sixteenth notes or four notes per beat. Sextuplets or six notes per beat is next. And finally, the last common subdivision you'll find is 32nd notes, and this is eight notes per beat. Man, after all those beats, I just feel like beating it. Now, I've included recognizable songs you can practice your reading chops to at my Patreon page below. Timeless classics like Jurassic Park, Star Wars, and Mary Had a Little Lamb. I like to imagine Mary was a babe who had more of an evil goat than a lamb, though. Now, once you have a basic understanding of how to read the notes on the staff, it's time to check out key signatures. A key signature tells you what notes are in each key, which is important, otherwise you end up sounding like shit. There are 12 keys in all, and the best way to visualize this is with the circle of fifths, or as I like to call it, the circle of death. Don't worry, it's not as hard as it looks. That's what she said. Starting at 12 o'clock, we've got the key of C major. There's no accidental notes in this key, and what I mean by accidental notes is sharps or flats. So that's all the white notes on the piano. Now each key has what's called a relative minor that shares the same notes. You can find the relative minor by going backwards three notes in the scale. For example, to find the relative minor of C, count C as 1, B as 2, and A as 3. So A minor is the relative minor of C major. Easy money. Next, let's proceed in a clockwise direction around the circle. Count up 5 notes from C to find the next key. C, D, E, F, G. So G major is our next key. G stands for gastrointestinal dysfunction. Now the key of G contains one sharp, which is F sharp. Go down a minor third or three notes in the scale to find the relative minor, which is E minor. Every guitarist's favorite key. The reason it's called the circle of fifths is because each key is a fifth apart. C to G equals 5 notes. The sharps themselves are also 5 notes apart. Thus, the number 5 is a big deal here. Now hang in there, because we're going to go through each and every key that exists. Go up 5 notes from G and you get our next key, D, as in, have a look at those double Ds. D major has 2 sharps, F sharp and C sharp, and the relative minor is B minor. B stands for Go up a fifth from D and you arrive at A. 3 sharps reside in the key of A. F sharp, C sharp, and G sharp. Don't make me get sharp with you. Go down a minor third from A to find the relative minor, and you get F sharp minor. Great key. Go up a fifth from A and you get E major, which has four sharps, F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, and D sharp. The relative minor here is C sharp minor, which I must say is quite delicious. Same key as Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath by Black Sabbath. I sure could use a sabbatical. Moving on, up a fifth from E, we get B major, containing the sharps F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, and A sharp. This is one of my absolute favorite keys to play in. It's very popular in progressive metal styles. Relative minor of B is G sharp minor. Now, F sharp major comes after B, containing six sharps. Too bad it's not 666 sharps. The sharps are F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, and E sharp. Now, some of you know that E sharp is the same note as F, which makes things a little confusing, but that's the whole point of music theory. Just kidding. It's notated this way so that we don't have to skip letters in the alphabet. Overall, there's, believe it or not, less confusion with this labeling system. The relative minor of F sharp major is D sharp minor, which guitar players tend to avoid like the plague. And finally, we arrive at the last key in the sharp side, which is C sharp major. There's seven sharps: F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp, E sharp, and B sharp. Pray for protection from the Dark Lord if you ever have to play in this key. It is no bueno. The relative minor is A sharp minor. Okay, so that's it for the sharp side of the circle of death. No study of music would be complete without intervals. So what is an interval? Well, an interval is simply the distance between two notes. Play anything more than two notes and you've failed to play an interval. Now, intervals are extremely important because without them, we wouldn't have scales or chords, which means we'd have no music, which means life would cease to exist. Is that what you want? The smallest interval in Western music is the minor second or half step. That'd be a C to a C sharp note. Ever get the feeling something's behind you? Check out John Williams' music in the movie Jaws to hear the sound of the minor second. Using popular songs or movie themes is a great way to remember the sound of each interval. Next is the major second interval, or C to D. It's less dissonant than the minor second, and it contains a whole step in between notes. The opening riff in Judas Priest, Breaking the Law, contains a major second. A minor third is three half steps, or C to E flat. This interval is essential in forming any minor chord. Use the first two chords in Tony Iommi's iconic riff Iron Man to remember this interval. The major third, or C to E, is next. It's built with four half steps, and this interval is essential for any major chord. Listen to Iron Maiden's Number of the Beast to hear it in action. The perfect fourth is next, C to F, or five half steps. I think of the song Here Comes the Bride to remember this one. Perfect opportunity to stop simping and work on your ear training. The most evil interval of all is next, known as Diabolos in Musica, or the Devil in Music. The augmented fourth, or tritone, divides the octave in half with six half steps. Play it three times and you get 666. Use Black Sabbath's Black Sabbath to remember the tritone. The perfect fifth is extremely important for metalheads because it's what makes the sound of a power chord, from C to G, or seven half steps. Hey baby, you're a perfect fifth. The main theme in Star Wars uses a perfect fifth interval. May the fifth be with you. Okay, we're over halfway through our intervallic investigation. Next is the minor sixth interval, or C to A flat. Eight half steps in between notes, and I like to use Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train to remember this one. The major sixth is from C to A, or nine half steps. I can't think of an iconic metal song that uses this interval, so we're gonna go with My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. Now, as a general rule of thumb, don't cross the ocean for your Bonnie. It's a lot of work, and additionally, it probably won't be appreciated. A minor seventh, or C to B flat, is 10 half steps. Man in a Box by Alice in Chains contains a minor seventh in the opening riff. So if you're feeling boxed in by your playing, try out this awesome interval. The major seventh is 11 half steps, or from C to B. Remember this interval with the classic Take On Me. For extra credit, grab the family jewels and see if you can nail the high note. The octave is our final interval, or from C to C. That'd be 12 half steps. The main riff in the Immigrant Song by Led Zeppelin is a perfect example of this interval. Now thank the Dark Lord below, because we've finally finished all of the intervals. Work on recognizing each one by downloading an ear training app like Good Ear, or recording your own quizzes for personal use. Also, see if you can hear and identify these intervals whenever you're listening to music. Exactly how fat are you? A scale can tell you that. Or perhaps you're more concerned with the scales of justice. Snakes also have scales. All jokes aside, though, this segment is about musical scales. Scales form the basic framework for how music is made. It's what gives each song its own unique character. So what is a scale? A scale is simply a series of intervals that connects an octave. You might say it's the very sound of music.
The first three notes just happen to be do, re, mi.
Do, re, mi.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti.
Dope. There's roughly 17 billion scales in total.
Billions and billions and billions and billions and billions and billions.
Nah, not quite that many. But seriously, there's a scale for every emotion you could ever feel and more. In a classical mood, try the harmonic minor scale. Feeling sad? Take the blues scale for a spin. Flooded with optimism? The major scale has got you covered. Speaking of the major scale, that's where we're gonna start. From C to C on the piano, or all the white notes, is the C major scale. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, dope. Let's hear it on the guitar now. You can use this specific number of half and whole steps to build a major scale on any note that you like. Here's the formula. Whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. A half step is one semitone, or from C to C sharp, for instance. A whole step is two semitones, or from C to D. Now, I have to say, don't just dismiss the major scale if you're a metalhead, because all of the diatonic modes that lie within the major scale can be very metal. Now, after you learn the major scale, it's time to check out the minor scale, for when shit goes south in life. A minor scale shares the same notes as C major and is called the relative minor scale. The reason the A minor scale sounds different yet still shares the same notes as C major is because of where the scale starts and stops. The sequence of intervals you get by playing all the white notes starting on A produces a melancholic vibe. And that's because of the first and third notes, which form a minor third interval. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, the vast majority of the music you're likely to hear is going to be used with these two scales, the major and the minor scale. However, there's more. Next most common scale to learn is harmonic minor. This is the one you're likely to hear if you're listening to a Bach or Mozart piece that sounds like it's in a minor key. It's exactly the same as the regular minor scale, except for one key difference, the raised seventh degree. Count up seven notes from the root and you arrive at the seventh degree, which is G. Raise this note one half step to a G sharp and bam, you've got instant harmonic minor. One Yngwie J. Malmsteen wouldn't have a career without this scale. Love you, Yngwie. Fuck donuts.